World reacts to Trump withdrawing World Health Organization funding. U.S. President Donald Trump has instructed his administration to temporarily halt funding to the World Health Organization, WHO, over its handling of the coronavirus pandemic. Trump said the WHO failed in its basic duty and it must be held accountable. He said it promoted China's disinformation about the virus that likely led to a wider outbreak. The United States is the biggest overall donor to the Geneva-based WHO, contributing more than $400 million in 2019, roughly 15% of its budget. Reaction to Trump's move was fast and furious worldwide. There is no time to waste. WHO's singular focus is on working to serve all people to save lives and stop the COVID-19 pandemic, Director General World Health Organization Chief Tedros Adhanom Ghebreyesus said on Twitter following Trump's decision. United Nations Secretary General Antonio Guterres. This is not the time to reduce resources for WHO operations, General Antonio said. Now is the time for unity and for the international community to work together in solidarity to stop this virus and its shattering consequences, he said. Chairman, U.S. House of Representatives Foreign Affairs Committee. With each passing day of this worsening crisis, the president is showing us his political playbook. Blame the WHO, blame China, blame his political opponents, blame his predecessors, do whatever it takes to deflect from the fact that his administration mismanaged this crisis and it's now costing thousands of American lives, Democratic Representative Elliot Engel. Johns Hopkins University Center for Health Security. The move sends the wrong message during the middle of a pandemic, said Dr. Amish Adalja, an infectious disease expert and senior scholar at the center. Adalja said the WHO does make mistakes, as it did in delaying the response to the Ebola outbreak in 2013 and 2014 in West Africa. He said reforms may be needed, but that work needs to take place after the pandemic has passed. It's not the middle of a pandemic that you do this type of thing, he said. Adalja said the WHO collects information about where the virus is active in every county in the world, which the United States needs to help guide decisions about when to open borders. African Union head Moussa Faki Mahamat. Faki Mahamat termed the decision deeply regrettable and said the world had a collective responsibility to help WHO during the COVID-19 pandemic. Russian Deputy Foreign Minister Sergei Ryabkov. We see yesterday's announcement by Washington on freezing funding of the WHO as most concerning. It is a sign of the very selfish approach of the U.S. authorities to what is happening in the world due to the pandemic, Deputy Foreign Minister Ryabkov told state news agency TASS. New Zealand Prime Minister Jacinda Ardern. At a time like this when we need to be sharing information and we need to have advice we can rely on, the WHO has provided that. We will continue to support it and continue to make our contributions, she said.